be a fine line between coincidence and irony.
You sure about that map?
Unfortunately, there was some nonsense about the discovery of the real King Arthur's tomb here years ago, soon discredited. And yet another roadside attraction was born.
Well, let's see what we can see, shall we? At least it should be educational. Either housekeeping should be fired, or no one's been inside for months. This place has seen better days.
It's been condemned since the death of the owner, one Professor Worth. I shudder to think that at one time he had students.
They must be electric. I'll have to find the power main.
The place is locked up pretty tight on the ground floor. Probably have to try up higher.
And we have power. Between stupid and charming with you, is there? Maybe the grunting Saxon, the Roman fascist that Alistair believes the whole legend was built around. This is where the truth behind the myth is supposed to be explained. It has been turned into a warehouse.
Fitting. There's been so little truth. truth everywhere else, why start here? The only factual basis behind the King Arthur myths died centuries before this place was built.
Give Professor Worth some credit. If he had to close an exhibit for renovations, at least he picked the most boring one. To raise this door.
Are you all right?
I decided to take the slow way down instead.
Should have told that to the forklift.
Please, Alistair. This will take some concentration.
Yeah, pipe down, Alistair. Or I won't let you sit up front with me anymore.
So am I.
That doesn't mean you don't have to be quiet anymore. It looks like there's oil seeping into the water table. Who knows how long it's been burning?
I wonder if the architect's design deliberately took this into account.
There's your answer, Alistair.
Wow. You know you're gonna ruin your boots.
Not on the path I'll need to take. them off the path. But it might have been worth trying just to hear you lads feel about it. We're through having fun. It's time to get back to business.
I'll take this time to adjust some travel arrangements I made. It shouldn't take too long.
Coward. Don't worry, Lara. I've still got an eye on you. Probably won't be able to hear each other too well when you're underwater, though.
There is a god.
Hey, I heard that.
This is brilliant.
That is interesting.
Thank you. real. They're all here. The court of Camelot.
You're sure about this? King Arthur, who wast verily of ye loins of Uther Pendragon?
I've no doubt about the authenticity of this tomb, Alistair. Arthur was the 11th century figure that became legend. The once and future king was as real then as the air I'm breathing now.
I don't know, Laura.
Excalibur, the sword in the stone. That's how it always goes, isn't it?
Pardon?
Swords in stones, Alistair. They're part of the monomyth. There wasn't just one Excalibur or one Merlin. We keep seeing swords and daises all over the world because they were everywhere.
So you're saying that everywhere they went, they raised up kings, shaping the course of human destiny?
Well, it's a possibility.
Who? And what happened to them and their swords?
Perhaps they're in Avalon. It's as good a place as any. Except our Merlin was killed and our Excalibur was left in pieces in the hands of the locals.
So where's Avalon?
I don't know. On the other side of the looking glass, perhaps? It says Bedivere returned a fragment of Excalibur to Arthur after the other pieces were carried off by the knights.
Where did they go?
To find Avalon, perhaps. The quest for the Holy Grail. Lancelot, Galahad, Percival and Bors. Their tombs are empty.
It says this fragment was left with Arthur to help him leave this mausoleum when the time came. Perhaps it will help me instead.
Sarah. What's up?
They didn't make off with your credit cards, did they? Is everything all right? Alistair?
I'm fine. Just not my usual evening routine.
Then let's go home.